Good evening. Our opening song is The God of All Grace, number 301. Please stand.
The God of all grace has blessed us this day. All of creation joins us in praise.
Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are Son of God and Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are Word made flesh and splendor of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Almighty God, have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace on earth, peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, heavenly King, O God Almighty,
Almighty ever-living God, lead us to a share in the joys of heaven, so that the humble flock may reach where the brave shepherd has gone before, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Paul and Barnabas continued on from Perga and reached Antioch in Pisidia. On the Sabbath, they entered the synagogue and took their seats. Many Jews and worshipers who were converts to Judaism followed Paul and Barnabas, who spoke to them and urged them to remain faithful to the grace of God. On the following Sabbath, almost the whole city gathered to hear the word of the Lord. When the Jews saw the crowds, they were filled with jealousy, and with violent abuse contradicted what Paul said. Both Paul and Barnabas spoke out boldly and said, "It was necessary that the word of God be spoken to you first, but since you reject it and condemn yourselves as unworthy of eternal life, we now turn to the Gentiles. For so the Lord has commanded us, 'I have made you a light to the Gentiles, that you may be an instrument of salvation to the ends of the earth.'" The Gentiles were delighted when they heard this and glorified the word of the Lord. All who were destined for eternal life came to believe, and the word of the Lord continued to spread through the whole region. The Jews, however, incited the women of prominence who were worshipers and the leading men of the city, stirred up a persecution against Paul and Barnabas, and expelled them from their territory. So they shook the dust from their feet in protest against them and went to Iconium. The disciples were filled with joy and the Holy Spirit, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the book of Revelations. I, John, had a vision of the great multitude, which no one could count, from every nation, race, people, and tongue. They stood before the throne and before the Lamb, wearing white robes and holding palm branches in their hands. Then one of the elders said to me, "These are the ones who have survived the time of great distress. They have washed their robes and made them white in the blood of the Lamb. For this reason they stand before God's throne and worship him day and night in his temple. The one who sits on the throne will shelter them. They will no longer hunger or thirst anymore, nor will the sun or any heat strike them. For the Lamb who is in the center of the throne will shepherd them and lead them to springs of life-giving water, and God will wipe away every tear from their eyes." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Jesus said, "My sheep hear my voice. I know them and they follow me. I give them eternal life and they shall never perish. No one can take them out of my hand. The Father who has given them to me is greater than all, and no one can take them out of the Father's hand. The Father and I are one." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
You probably can't see it from over here, but in front of the altar is an icon of the Good Shepherd. Father Jim Sauer painted that for me, either for my 40th or 45th wedding anniversary, or ordination. This is not being, probably is, for my ordination anniversary. I tried to get a hold of him today to find out whether he remembered which one it was, but he didn't return my call. But, you know, if you get a chance to look at it, if you've ever seen anyone or known anyone to have painted an icon for some of the colors, there are layers upon layers upon layers of colors to get just the right color. So I appreciated that when he gave it to me for that anniversary. But today is called Good Shepherd Sunday, and we heard it in two of our readings, our second reading and the gospel reading. You know, even though we may not have a real close contact with sheep, we did have on our farm for several years. I think we had five of them, and they were in a way kind of a nuisance because they had a habit of hurting themselves. So we would have to catch them and treat them. But my most vivid memory of sheep and shepherds and shepherding is from the trip to the Holy Land, where we were out, you know, in the far distant areas and in the rocky soil and the lava waste and all of that, where we saw the Bedouin shepherd. His shelter was a sheet of tin against a piece of wood near a rock, and that was all he had for shelter from any storms. But you know, he was also had a walking stick and just bare clothing, and he walked around leading his goat, who had a bell on it, which was the thing that the sheep followed. And that's why they have, if you've ever seen anything with goats and sheep, they're the kind of leaders of the sheep. But certainly, you know, when we look at the Holy Land and the shepherd, it sandals on just, you know, he really had to find food, because when you're out in the rocky ground and kind of a lava waste, there's not much vegetation that grows there. And so he had to constantly be looking for someplace for them to graze. But they had to rely on him for finding food. You know, it's also sparse there, but, you know, he had to heal their wounds. They knew his voice. They knew when the shepherd spoke, because I noticed when we had the sheep, you know, we could get among them. We could catch them to treat them. But if any strangers came, they would run to the other side of the path. But our neighbor also, Fred Binty, had a whole flock of sheep. And I remember the ram that was in the flock. He was okay as long as you kept your eye on him. But if you turned your back on him, you were gone, down on the ground, namely, because he would get behind you and boot you one. But certainly in our second reading from the book of Revelation, you know, it refers to the Lamb of God, who is Jesus. And in the gospel reading, it says, "My sheep hear my voice, I know them, and they follow me." And I think, you know, it's kind of appropriate for Mother's Day, really, you know, some of these things that we think about in regards to sheep and shepherding. For instance, this one has him carrying a lamb on his shoulders, you know. And when we were kids, how much our mothers carried us around and cared for us. They gave us birth. They nourished us. They made sure that we had food. They looked out for us. We were hurt or in any way, whether it was through sickness or injury, you know, they bound up our wounds and did everything to make us well. They were always concerned about us. You know, somebody made a comment one time, no matter how old you are, how young you are, once a child, always a child. Once a parent, always a parent, no matter how old they are or how old you are. And that's certainly true. You know, there isn't a parent that isn't concerned about their children all the length of their life and always concerned about what they are all about. But as we also celebrate, you know, Mother's Day, to think in terms of the statue that's right in front of us that came here. Well, it was being put up when I came at about a little bit before 4 o'clock. And, you know, is to think about Mary, our mother, as one who cares for us. You know, at the foot of the cross, you know, Jesus said, "Woman, behold your son, behold your mother." And it made Mother Mary the mother of all of us who are her children. And so today we honor her in a special way as well, as we do through the month of May, one of the months that May and October are generally called months dedicated to Mary. And so we honor her today as we come together for Good Shepherd Sunday and honor Mother's Day. So, you know, if your mother's still living, do something special for her for Mother's Day. If she's deceased, remember her in prayer, because she took such good care of you all the days of your life. Please stand now as we make our profession of faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, three in all things created, for us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate on the earth.
received from the Spirit, and he is again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will never end. I believe in the Holy Spirit,
Lord, the giver of life,
who proceeds from the Father and the Son,
who with the Father and the Son is
worshipped,
who has
spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church.
I confess all
baptism of the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead, and life of the world to come.
Amen. As wandering sheep who call out to the shepherd for guidance and protection, let us bring our needs and petitions to the Lord, who never abandons us.
For the church, may God strengthen all who have been anointed her leaders and who share in the one baptism we profess. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the Supreme Court, may the Holy Spirit inspire the court with wisdom and courage to protect life at all stages. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
On this World Day of Prayer for Vocations, we pray for an increase in vocations in our parish and diocese. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For teachers and catechists in this faith community, may God be their guide as they share the gospel message with joy and generosity. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Jack Andrew Raven, who will be baptized this weekend, let us pray to the Lord. For all who have died, may the Lord lovingly welcome them into the heavenly banquet. Let us pray to the Lord. For Agnes Teagan, for whom this Mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord. For all those intentions that we hold in the quiet of our heart,
Almighty Father, you hear our prayers and know our needs. Please grant what we ask according to your will, through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
The offertory song is number 620, Like a Shepherd, number 620.
Shepherd, he feeds his flock and gathers the lambs in his arms, holding them carefully close to his heart, leading them home. Say to the cities of Judah, prepare to the mountain.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Grant, we pray, O Lord, that we may always find delight in these Paschal mysteries, so that the renewal constantly at work within us may be the cause of our unending joy, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. Through him the children of light rise to eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful. For his death is our ransom from death, and his rising, the life of all, has risen. Therefore, overcome with Paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." A mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity together with Francis our Pope and Joseph our Bishop and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven,
hallowed be thy name.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us now offer each other some sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
The communion song is number 704, Hail Mary, Gentle Woman, number 704.
Let us pray. Look upon your flock
kind shepherd, and be pleased to settle in eternal pastures the sheep you have redeemed by the precious blood of your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Special prayer for mothers on Mother's Day. Loving God, as a mother gives life and nourishment to her children, so you watch over your church. Bless these women that they may be strengthened as Christian mothers. Let the example of their faith and love shine forth. Grant that we, their sons and daughters, may honor them always with a spirit of profound respect. Grant this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God. Our closing song is number 443, How Can I Keep From Singing?
My life flows on in endless song, above earth's lamentation.
Though the darkness round me close, songs in